Good morning, students. Today we will take the very global topic, that is a globalization, which is a very influencing too after 1991 when the liberalization and globalization take place in our country in Narasimha Rao government, and WTO takes a place in the market of globalization. So first, what is the globalization? Globalization is the process of interaction and integration among people, companies and government worldwide. Worldwide means globally, the companies, the people and the industries are interrelated or integrations amongst people. This increase in global interaction has caused a growth in the international trade and the exchange of idea and culture. Here, we can say that the globalization to meet and work with the people, industry, and the culture globally around the world or universe. Here are some definitions of globalization. In that scenario, the first is the movement towards the expansion of economic and social ties between countries through the spread of corporate institutions and the capitalist philosophy that leads to the shrinking of the worlds in economic terms. So here you can say like that when the boundaries or the borders are open or territory are open to the all the people in the world. Before the globalizations, there are several restrictions and several borders to do the trade. And the peoples of around the world, from around the world, have to face or pay some taxes, duties to do their business and interact with each other. Then the process by which people, their ideas and their activities in different parts of the world become intercounted and integrated. Means here in globalization, there is not only doing the business, it is the cultural exchange too. Activities exchange too take place in the term of globalization. Globalization as a term is new, but the process is not, because before this term, when it's come into the working, the term is using in the format of GATE. GATE, a tariff regulatory report tha, regular regulation tha, ट्रेड एंड टैरिफ का. उसके अंदर हम लोग एक दूसरे के देशों के साथ, अलग अलग कंट्रीज के साथ, पहले के टाइम में सौदागर आते थे, वो सब लोग आपस में इंटरेक्ट करके बिजनेस करते थे. बट 91 क्या आ गया, ओपन मार्केट कर दिया गया, लिबरलाइजेशन कर दिया गया, प्राइवेटाइजेशन कर दिया गया, तो मार्केट ग्लोबल हो गया. बाय द ग्लोबलाइजेशन द सो मेनी अपॉर्चुनिटीज विल ओपन फॉर द यंगस्टर्स. इट शोज हाउ द वर्ल्ड हैज श्रंक and how people, goods and information can be moved easily around the world. Obviously, by the help of globalization, so many peoples can move here and there and do their business. For them, the world is so shrinked position that anytime, anywhere you can move by the help of globalization opportunities. Here are the sum of the five elements. Here I am presenting you some of the only five elements of globalizations, which compile and can say the principle of globalization. In this, first one is international trade, then foreign direct investment, FDI, capital market flows, migration of movement of labor, capital and all the factor of productions, and diffusion of technology. Diffusion of technology means technology exchange. Means iske baad aata hai aapka, what are the seven major types of globalization? Globalization ke types. Aap kahenge globalization ke types kya honge? Means jab boundaries khule hain, border khule hain, to sabke liye khule hain, usme alag alag kya hoga? No, because as we discussed earlier, that globalization means not only within the trade or for trade or for business purpose only. It is open for all the aspects. So the all the aspects will make a different type of globalization. In this scenario, the first globalization type is financial globalization, world's financial system have become intimately interconnected. They can talk, they can exchange their currencies, they can use their currencies, their market so easily globally. Then second one is economic globalization, then technological globalization, political globalization, cultural globalization, sociological globalization, ecological globalization, and geographical globalization. Here are the several type of globalization in this area. So you can say this, that globalization can refer to a number of different areas of concentration or constriction. Globalization examples include political, economic, social, and culture and technological, etc., in addition to information and ecological. Now the next slide, we will move to the next slide, that is here we will describe to the examples of globalizations, that how the globalization are working after the 1991. Pepsi, here I show you a graph or the chart which is have so many examples of globalizations. So in this there are some major companies from the outside of India or outside the different countries, and place the different countries and the home country are different, but they are working around the world wonderfully and do their job more wonderfully rather than their home country itself, like Pepsi, Coke, Nestle, Facebook, the burning companies, Amway, BlackBerry, Tata, McDonald's, Satyapal, Honda, and Versace. So in this scenario, you can say that globalization just opened the market for the all over the world's people, not only the inside the people, not only for domestic one, for the international one. Now we will move the next slides. Next is the impact of globalization in India. So जब इतना globalization हो गया तो impact obviously आना ही आना है. So both impact is there, positive as well as negative. In positive impact, the greater competition among producer, both local and foreigner producer, has been of advantage to consumer. There is greater choice before these consumer who now enjoy improved quality and lower price for several products. Now when the globalization come, the producer are in number of rapidly increasing rather than the consumer. So now the consumer have a lot of choice for a one product and to get a better opportunity or the better product at a cheaper price. So the consumer is benefiting by the globalization. Foreign investment has increased. The foreign investment has increased. The foreign companies are come to your country, come to India, you can say, and invest their capital to enhance their business. And they got a very good market in India. And nowadays, India has a great investor too in the debt foreign companies in debt land only. Now, by this chart, you can easily understand that what is actually globalization. Here, move you job, आपको एक job provide करता है for unemployment के लिए. क्या है unemployed peoples के लिए? It provides a job, a new opportunity, a bulk of opportunity to go and grab it on. Move up to a better job, get a wider job scope for those who already in a job. Those peoples who already in a job but wants to a better opportunity or to grow rapidly, they can get easily a wider scope of job in their market or in their core area. Then for those working in sectors that may not be doing well, now it works, globalization works also for that sectors which sectors are not working well. So for that sectors, peoples move across industry. They can move easily across the industry to chance, to get the chance for the employment, for the better opportunity, and to improve their living standards. Next, for workers in industry that may not be doing एज वेल एज अ होल, जो अच्छा नहीं कर रहे हैं उनके लिए क्या है, मूव बिटवीन सेक्टर्स इन द इंडस्ट्री, डिफरेंट सेक्टर्स ओपन होते हैं जिसमें वो इजीली मूव कर सकते हैं. नाउ वी विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड्स, दैट इज पॉजिटिव इफेक्ट्स ऑफ ग्लोबलाइजेशन. व्हाट आर द पॉजिटिव इफेक्ट्स? पॉजिटिव मीन्स टू, देयर आर सेवरल पॉजिटिव इफेक्ट्स ऑफ ग्लोबलाइजेशन, एंड द फर्स्ट वन इज एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, टू इंक्रीज द एम्प्लॉयमेंट. द अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट रेट डिक्रीजिंग, द एजुकेशन लेवल इज हाई, द लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड इज हाई, एंड द मेडिकल्स and the medical facility and the health health facilities will increasing, banking sector is increasing, is only due to the positive effects of globalization. In this higher living standards, development of infrastructures, you can see around you that the infrastructure of India before the 91 and after the 91 and nowadays is a huge difference between both of them times. And what are the negative effect is, because there are several types of company and countries are involved in one country to do the same work, they give the opportunity, they produce the commodity at a same price or different prices, so there are the race in a cutthroat competition. एक दूसरे से आगे निकलने के लिए फटाफट से क्या करते हैं, जैसे बोलते हैं ना कि चाइनीज माल आ गया है, तो वो ग्लोबलाइजेशन की वजह से है, तो कुछ लोग क्या करेंगे उसकी तरफ अट्रैक्ट होंगे ड्यू टू देयर चीप रेट, चाहे उनका क्वालिटी कैसा है कुछ भी है, तो आप उसकी तरफ ज्यादा झुक जाते हैं. तो कट थ्रॉट कॉम्पिटिशन विल रेज एंड राइज इन मोनोपोली. राइज इन मोनोपोली, देर आर समटाइम्स देर आर अ मोनोपोली टू. Like before the globalization, there are no Samsung, no Sony, no Philips in India set up. But after the globalization, Samsung has a monopoly in some types of products. LG is a monopoly in some type of products. Sony has their monopoly. So monopoly will raise after the globalizations, and the cheaper industry or the small scale industries lay down or the wash out in the shadow of monopolist companies. The next is, what is the advantages of globalizations? Globalizations gives a larger market. It provides a large market and a scope to sell their product and commodity at a very good price and earn the very handsome profit and to increase the living of standards. As the all customer, all the consumers now wants the different types of items or different types of commodity, but at a very cheap price. So they have a very, very much choice to choose the best one to use there to consume that items. So that by this, their living standards will by default will be increasing day by day. Exchange of knowledge and culture at international level. By the globalization itself, there are several types of exchange knowledge program, cultural program, culture knowledge. There are different types of universities who organize the different culture exchange programs at international levels too. In this scenario, IITs in India are organize a festival of international festival of exchange the knowledge program, and IIM etc. These the big institutes are provides the different cultural international level exchange programs too. Selection and choices of goods and services. It is becoming very much easy to choose the goods and services at a very cheap price, but in the quality wise it is very good. So the customer or the consumer are very much beneficial by the globalization to choose their services, to choose their commodities to use at a very cheap or affordable prices, but the services and the product commodities quality will be very high. Next, mutual understanding among the nation increased and world become a better market. Mutual understanding means, so once you enter the global market, you have to mutualize yourself with the another world market, so that the world market will be the better and better day by day. Where there are a lot of advantages of globalization, we cannot deny that there are the several disadvantages of globalization too, but we have to overlapping the disadvantages or pick up the advantages from the disadvantages too. In this lines, there is a first disadvantage is it creates unemployment in developed countries. Who already developed that countries facing the problem of unemployment. And the business and the big companies are the only winner in globalization. Only the big shots or big companies are the winner, and the small scale industry or the small industrialist or the low capital industry are win out in the crashes of big companies. It can increase the spread of communication diseases. Obviously, अभी आप देख लीजिए दिन रात आप फोन पर हैं, इधर हैं, उधर हैं, तो कम्युनिकेशन डिजीजेस मींस जितना भी तरह का आपका काम है वो सब आप एक तरह से पूरा मशीनरी हो गया है, सब कुछ आप मैकेनिकल करते हैं, वर्चुअल करते हैं, डिजिटलाइज कर दिया आपने अपने आप को. दिस विल हेल्पफुल, दिस विल वेरी मच हार्मफुल टू योर हेल्थ एज वेल एज योर लाइफ टू. Harmful effect on small industries and small businesses. Harmful effects of consumerism. Companies face much greater competition. All the local companies, all the local market has to face the big competition from the around world. And sometimes they cannot face the competition and they ruin themselves. So this is all about the globalization. And now we has come to that conclusion that the impact of globalization of Indian economy is critical fusion of rewards and cost. Certain economic indicators like GDP, foreign direct investment, forex reserve, etc. had a position phase, but indicators like unemployment, poverty, education, health, social issue were not so up to the mark. In such situation of projection and expectations, the role of Indian policy makes it certainly very crucial. They have to adopt such policy and execute such programs which can optimize the positive effects and minimize the evil effects of the most talked about phenomena called globalization. So we have to choose the best one and the fruit for, or the sweet fruit for, from the bitter fruit of the globalization's evil effects. Only the way we can move on the globalizations and we can grow like a star or a sun. So this is all about the globalizations, and a very thanks to all of you.